Hello everyone, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Will Warren, and today I'm gonna show you the Rockwood Geo Pro 19FD. Now the Geo Pro is from a company called Rockwood. Rockwood happens to be the number one seller of fiberglass travel trailers in the entire country. Nobody comes close. This line is a brand new line. It's only been around for about a year, and it is taking over the industry by storm. It may not have quite the numbers since this just came out, but these things sell faster than hotcakes. And the reason why is that they are lightweight, easily towed, and they are loaded with options. The 19FD in particular is a great unit for a couple. It's lightweight, easy to get up into the mountains. It's small enough, you can find a spot for it easily. So let's get started. Let me start showing you the features. I think you guys will really fall in love with this unit. All right, now here I am on the passenger side of the 19FD, and I wanted to show you this awning. So this is an electric awning, push button remote, and it just rolls, push button on the wall, rolls in and out, and it's adjustable too. So if you want to, you can drop down a side of this, and this is really useful for rains. It keeps the water from pooling on it. It kind of runs it off, and in this case, it sends the water away from the door, so you don't have a big mud puddle right by your door. Now right over here, you happen to have a storage compartment as well as your water filtration system. So this unit does have a 10,000 gallon water filtration system on board, and it goes down to a filtration of 0.9 microns, and that's a residential grade. So if you're operating off of well water, it's gonna take out all those floaties for you. This, of course, is your hot water heater. Now this is a 6 gallon hot water heater, and you can run this on either propane or electric. And when you're plugged in, it'll actually recover at a rate of 16.2 gallons per hour. So it won't run on electric off of your battery. You have to be plugged in. But if you're not plugged in, just flip it over to gas and you have hot water. Now right here, I want to mention the frameless windows. So all of these are a bonded frameless windows. They open up by kind of pulling away from the coach just like this, and that's useful because you can have them open in the rain. You don't have to worry about water getting inside. Directly below the awning, you notice this large strip of LED lights, and that provides a lot of light in the evening. The orange light is a light that you can flip on, and it doesn't attract quite as many insects. So if you want to just flip it on to come out and do something real quick, that's a great way to go. The outside speaker, of course, plays music from your media player on the inside, and that'll play CDs, radio, all that kind of stuff for you. Now right below the window is this bar, and obviously it's right now it's holding up a table for us. The other thing that it'll hold up as well is a grill. So this unit does come with a propane grill, and it attaches onto this bar as well. Normally, actually, this would probably be slid over here, and then you would have your grill here because you have an LP quick connect right here for the RVQ grill. So you can just plug your hose into that to get propane to that. You also, right here, I want to mention, you have your, of course, tire wheel axle. Now the axles on these are torsion suspended, so that gives each wheel independent suspension from the other. So if you're going down a road that's uneven, this makes for a much nicer tow. They're also nitrogen filled tires, and they have the aluminum rims as well. The aluminum, of course, doesn't rust out like steel does, and it also dissipates that road heat a little bit more quickly too. So right underneath, let's slide this back over. Right underneath the bar here, you happen to have a GFI outlet, so if you want to plug in some extension cords, you can do that really easily there. And then down here, I want to mention this little circular piece here. This, whoops, well, don't do that, but this right here is just a lid that covers your storage for your outside sewer hose. So it makes a nice place to store it without having to stink up any other storage compartment in your unit. Now Rockwood comes with a large grab handle, and this can be stowed like that when you're traveling. It's much nicer than the small little ones they give you. It helps you get in and out really easily. The door itself, you can see, has a nice window to let some light in. It also happens to have a nice keyless entry. So you can program this to whatever code you want, And that way, if you happen to come in and you're missing your keys, you can still get into your unit. It operates on a friction hinge, and you'll notice that the door is radiused. So if you were to, say, drop down, whoops, you have to undo this before you drop down the awning. But if you were to drop down the awning, this radius, right, is gonna keep you from damaging the awning fabric. Now, the friction hinge keeps it from slamming back and forth in high winds. And then this right here is, of course, your screen door. So you can use this if you want to get a little extra ventilation, a little extra light as well. You got two steps up into the entry also, more frameless windows here, and then you have another storage compartment, which is nice to have. So any bit of storage that they can give you in a Rockwood, they generally try to. There's your power cord as well. Now you notice it's not pass-through, and there's an important reason for that, actually really fun reason for that. So we'll get to that when we go inside. But let's talk about the front here real quick. So you have a full full fiberglass front cap. And then down here, you have a diamond plate rock shield, of course, that's gonna absorb all the rock strikes that maybe your vehicle might kick up on the road. Now the best thing about the front though is this right here. So this comes, we optioned it with a bike rack for you. So you can easily stow up to, I think it's two bikes on this unit here. And so you don't have to worry about putting anything on the roof or trying to figure out where to put your bikes in your tow vehicle as well. There's two 20-pound propane tanks, and they have an automatic crossover, so if one runs dry, it'll flip over to the other. And the 20-pounders are nice because you can just go exchange them if you don't have a place to fill at locally. There's also a battery disconnect down here as well. So when you go to store this, you can simply unplug this switch here. That kills all power inside the coach, so it saves your battery. And when you're ready to use it, you just turn it on there, that completes the circuit, and you have power again. That's really helpful because your LP detector and your smoke detector will always draw power. There's no way to shut those off. Now, earlier I said the weight of this is extremely low, and it is. It's a very lightweight camper. Your dry weight on it is 2,973 pounds. So it's just under 3,000 pounds for this thing sitting dry. Now, if you want to talk about the GVWR, which is always important, the GVWR on the coach is the axle rating, so how much the axle can handle with a full load of cargo plus the dry weight of the camper. That number on this unit is 3,897. So you have about 900 pounds of cargo capacity, or 900 pounds that you can fill this with and still be within range on the axle. Now, something this size, 900 pounds, to some people may not seem like a lot, but that is a lot of weight. You're talking, if you fill up the water tank on this, you're maybe sitting around 300 pounds. That's still 600 pounds of cargo to fit inside this. So unless you're bringing your weights and you plan on pumping some iron, that's more than enough weight for you to go camping with. Now, as we go down the side of the coach, there's another storage compartment right here. And you have, you know, crank for your jacks, bag for your power cord, and also your propane cord as well. You know, something else I just wanted to mention really quick too is the kind of vehicle that can haul this. With those weights that I was just mentioning, you know, any half-ton truck can haul this, but a lot of SUVs can, your Sequoias, even maybe your newer Highlanders if they have the tow package. But you know, you can always check your tow rating on your coach in your owner's manual. Go into the towing section, there's a max trailer weight, and that's a real good clue on how much you can haul. Now, as we move down the side of the coach, you have more frameless windows. They try to give you as many windows to let in as much light as possible. This right here is always a nice feature. It's the outside shower. So you can turn the hot and cold to get it to whatever temperature you like. And this little switch right here, I want to show you this, right? So what this switch does is once you get the temperature to where you like, you can flip it on to shower off, and then you can pause it, and you don't have to turn off your knobs and then return them on and get it to the temperature you want. All you got to do is flick that switch and you're back on and running at the temperature that you like. Oh, now directly below this, let me show you this here. This is what you call a black tank flush. So when you go to dump out your black tank, which holds all your toilet waste, it's nice if you can flush that out and clean it out, you know, eliminate any smells building up while it's just sitting in storage. So you connect a hose to this, that'll fill up that tank, then you can pull the valve, flush it. You can even do that multiple times if you want to give it a real thorough cleaning. This is your furnace exhaust, in case you're wondering. And then this is where you fill up your water tank. So if you're gonna be operating without pressurized water, a city water connection available, you'll wanna fill up this tank. And then when you get going, get to wherever you're going, you just flip onto your water pump and that'll pressurize your water system for you and feed off that tank. Now, of course, here's the other side of the axle. Again, torsion suspended, aluminum rims. This right here is for your fridge. A lot of people wonder what that's for. All right, now right here is where you have a cable and satellite connections. So this is your cable, that's your satellite. So if you have portable satellite, you can connect it to there and get your TV that way. This is your 30 amp power connection. So this does come with a 30 amp cable. And we also give you a little adapter that'll adapt that 30 amp down to a regular 110 connection. If you don't happen to have a 30 amp connection nearby, you can use that to at least get run power and cool down your fridge, you know, have lights, that kind of a thing. There is an AC unit on board and that 30 amp connection will allow you to run that AC. Also, good thing to note here is this little Furion connection. This little clear piece right here is actually a light. So if you plug in and for some reason there was a problem with your cord or the outlet, then this won't light up. But if you do, if you are getting power, it lights up green for you. Now down below is your dump station. So this is your black tank and your black valve, and this is your, sorry, your black pipe and black valve. This is your gray pipe and your gray valve. Now that is closed, this is open, and we close it like that. And then, of course, this is where you can dump your tanks at. And it's always nice to pull your black tank first and dump all your toilet waste, and then pull your gray valve and let that flush out your sewer hose for you. And then these right here, these little knobs with the red and the blue PEX lines, those are your low point drains. So when you go to winterize the coach and you need to drain your water system, you just open these two valves and they'll drain all that out for you. Now on the back of the coach, there's some things I want to definitely point out. So at the very top, you'll notice that there's a radius on the roof, meaning it's curved. And that's really important because that helps to shed the water off, leave no standing water. And the two little spouts you see up there are designed to shoot the water away from the coach. That way, if it's really dusty, murky water on top that's running off, you know, it's not going to leave black streaks down the side. Something else to point out, at the top, you see that kind of black box that's vented. It has all those vent slats in it. That's for a fan in the back. Bathroom, and that allows you to open that up even when you're driving down the road, even in the rain, and air out the inside. We'll show you that in a minute. And then right here is a little plug here. This is a black dummy plug for a backup camera. So if you want to, you can purchase a Furion backup camera. We take out the dummy plug, plug it in, stick that camera in place, and then it wirelessly syncs to a screen that goes into your truck, and you can put that on the dash or wherever, and then you have a backup camera ready to go. All the lights I should mention on the outside of this are all LED, including these lights here, the running lights up above. And then this is your city water connection. So if you happen to be at a campground where there is pressurized water, you just simply connect the hose to this, connect it to the spigot, turn the spigot on, and you have pressurized water in your coach without running the water pump. Hey guys, come on in. Let me show you the inside of this 19. So right here by the door, of course you have your window that I wanted to show off kind of from the inside here. And then up here, this is important. This is where your control panel is. So you can check your battery, see how your battery's doing, check your black tank, gray tank, fresh tank. You can also turn off the lights in here, so we can turn off the interior lights if we want to, make it really dark, flip them back on. You can control your awning from here, your water pump and water heater. Now at the front of the coach, you have your couch, and then you might be wondering, where is the bed? Well, that is the bed right there. So you have a Murphy bed on this setup, and that of course maximizes the space when you're talking about 19 feet. So when you're ready to go to sleep, you simply fold down the couch. They give you a little handle right here to help fold it down. And then you undo these latches on each side. Being sure not to put your fingers right in here where they'll get smushed. You just lower it down, and there you have your bed. Now these straps right here are convenient because you can leave your sheets and your comforter and your pillows on and use those two straps to keep everything locked in place. That way you don't have to unmake your bed and remake it every time you're folding it up or down. And kind of talking about linens, let's talk about your wardrobe space. So you have two wardrobes on each side of the bed as well. In addition to that, you have the two nightstands, which is really a simple thing, but a lot of trailers lack that space. On this side, you have a 12-volt charging station, so you can charge your 12-volt devices, phone, just plug it in with USB. You also happen to have a 110 connection right back here. So if you want to use your regular home charger, you can do that as well. Or maybe you have a CPAP machine, you can hook it up that way too. There's also one on the other side as well, if you need that too. And then something else to mention is that you have windows on each side, which is pretty important. You can open those up at night and get a nice cross breeze. Sometimes up here in Colorado, it cools off so much at night from the temperature of the day that sometimes that's all you need. You don't need to run your AC. But if you do want to run your AC, you have that right up there. So that is just it's a controlled right on the AC box itself. You just flip it on, turn it how cold you want, if you want the fan running high or low, and it'll make this whole place into an ice box if you want it to. Now also right above me is this little device right here. This is for your TV antenna. So this picks up HD digital channels. So wherever you are at, you can use this to program your TV, get whatever local stations are available. You can also kind of rotate it, and that's actually rotating the TV antenna up on the outside if you need to kind of fiddle with it to get a better signal. Now let's fold up this bed real quick. I should also mention that you have some storage here on the front. And to fold up the bed, you lift it up like that. There's also storage underneath the couch as well. And there's the couch set up. Now here you got the kitchen area. You have another outlet. You'll notice Rockwood, they try to give you a lot of outlets. There's a little extension for your counter space as well right here. So you can use that to have just a little extra room to work with. You have your stainless steel sink. Of course, hot and cold water. And then this is nice, this flush mount stove cover. It gives you extra prep space. And when you're ready to cook, simply flip it up like that and you have your backsplash available. You also happen to have, of course, storage, one drawer, one little scrubby cubby. And then you happen to have two storage areas up here. You can use that for dishes or dry pantry space. A lot of folks, they'll use their oven to store pots and pans and things like that, because most RVers I've met, they never ever touch the oven. And then there's a storage area down here. You could also use that for pots and pans as well. Now right here you have your microwave, and then this is your fridge. Let me close that door. So this is bigger than some of the other Geo Pro models. You get a taller fridge in this one. You also happen to have a little built-in freezer as well. Now this fridge will operate off of electricity, plug-in electricity, so shore power or a generator, not your battery. And it'll also run off of propane. So if you're dry camping without power, you can still use your propane to cool down your fridge. Now on the opposite of the kitchen, we have our dinette area. So again, you got a nice window. I want to show you this too. They put in the roller shades as well. So you just pull that down, pops into place. You can stop it wherever you want. You can also open up the window just like that. That's how these windows open up from the inside, with a twist of a knob. And then the table here can actually be folded down into a secondary bed. So the table goes, it rests on these little supports right here, and then you fill in with the rest of these cushions in order to make another bed. And underneath this side of the dinette, you happen to have even more storage right there. Under this side of the dinette, you have access to, I believe it's your hot water heater from right here, which is why this one is actually screwed in place. Now you can just undo that screw, undo the screw on that side, two screws, open it up, and you have access for servicing. And then this right here is your entertainment center. So you can flip this on, get your radio, you can play your CDs through this. There's an HDMI port as well. There's a USB port if you want to charge devices over here. Storage throughout. And also, it does come with a TV, which mounts right here. It's on a swivel mount, so you can kind of direct it wherever you want it to go. We've removed it right now, but it does come with it. And then this is pretty exciting. This is a spot for a solar panel controller. So if you want to mount the solar panel on the roof, it's already pre-wired for you. We just simply plug it in on the roof, seal it. We plug in the controller right into here and you're automatically charging your batteries. Now there's also a port on the outside if you just wanted to use a portable solar panel, you can do that as well. All right guys, come on back here. Let me show you the bathroom real quick. So obviously I'm standing right now in the shower and slash tub. So if you do happen to have a little kid or something like that, the tub is kind of nice. You can bathe them right here in it. If you're an adult, of course, you'll be utilizing the shower. It has the same kind of knob right here, so you can control the temp, you can leave the temperature as is and shut it on and off as needed. There's also a little dome right here, so you know, just so you're not, since you have a roof that's curved, this keeps you from knocking your head all over the place. Of course, you have your sink and you have your medicine cabinet here as well, and storage beneath the cabinet, and an outlet in case you have an appliance you need to plug in. Toilet is right there, followed by linen, wardrobe, storage, whatever you really want to do right there. Now on the outside, we also discussed that there is a little cover for a fan. This is that fan. So this right here moves 920 cubic feet of air per minute. There's four different speed settings on it you can change it to. So when you have it set at the highest setting, it'll act like a whole house fan and kind of circulate all the air out of the coach, which is really nice. If all you got to do is open your windows, you can get a nice breeze. And again, you can just press a button to shut that off, leave it open while you're driving down the road or while it's raining. Thank you guys for watching our video on the Rockwood Geo Pro 19FD. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it informative. If you guys have a question for us regarding this, please leave us a comment. Let us know. We try to get back to those as quick as we can. If you want to talk to us about this product or any of the others you may have seen on our channel, you can always give us a call. Our number here is 970-313-4337, and you can visit us online at www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. And if you guys really like this video, please hit that subscribe button and click the little bell next to it. You'll get an alert as soon as we upload additional content. We upload a lot of content very regularly, so keep informed, you know, and if you have any questions, again, let us know. My name is Will. I'd be happy to answer them for you, and thank you for watching. We hope to see you next time.